Welcome back to Madison Square Garden, where the Lightning and Rangers are set to meet as we have another look at our starting netminders.
Matthew Garon in the net tonight. You see the numbers that he has put up. Pretty decent save percentage for Matthew. And the King, Henrik Lundqvist. Tremendous numbers. As you see there, that save percentage amongst the leaders in the league. Guy Boucher behind the bench in his second year with the Lightning, and of course, former coach of the Tampa Bay Lightning, now the boss behind the bench for the Rangers, John Tortorella.
Referees for this game, Chris Rooney will handle the opening faceoff, working with David Banfield. Lonnie Cameron, Vaughn Roddy are the linesmen for this one. We would like to welcome everybody looking into the watch party at Curtis Hixon Park in downtown Tampa, and looking for a Lightning win as our coverage in HD and Sun Sports presented as usual by our friends at HH Gregg. And certainly everybody at the watch party wishing Marty St. Louis well as he has been attended to at NYU Medical Center. Head athletic trainer Tom Mulligan alongside, and he's expected to return back to Tampa immediately when he's able to, and the swelling subsides, he'll get further examination. For now, he is out indefinitely as a result of those injuries suffered right around the left eye. As the Rangers go to work on the Lightning zone, the puck is played out to center by Steven Stamkos. Ryan McDonough takes it for New York. They're without an important defenseman, not only Mark Stahl, who hasn't been with them all season long, but Michael Sauer suffering a concussion in that Leaf game the other night, Chief, which they lost at that end of their five-game winning streak.
A lot of teams with injuries. Lightning now with four guys on the sidelines with injuries. St. Louis, Thompson, Kubina, and Matty Oland. Evan Oberg, of course, recalled, but is yet to play. He's healthy. Stahl, Ruff's back skating. Wolski, Sauer is the new guy, as Rick pointed out. So they've two of their top four defensemen are out in the Rangers.
Steve Emminger with a shot that's blocked. Tom Pyatt, former Ranger property on this line, as he works with Vinny LeCavalier and Teddy Purcell. Out in front, Artem Anisimov with a shot that's off the glass behind the net. Kept back of the goal by Marion Gaborik. LeCavalier having to leave his man go, Derek Stepan. Anisimov trying to center against Matt Gilroy, of course, former Ranger with them his first 2 years in the NHL before joining the Lightning this season. Rangers hold it down low as it's handed off to Gaborik. That shot was blocked. Taken now by Teddy Purcell. He'll circle behind the net. Out for Clark. Puck knocked out of the air by Michael Delzato, and the play is ruled offside.
John Tortorella talked exclusively about that, how Emminger had to move up and play with Delzato, and he thought that it's, you know, that's not that big of a difference. Obviously, when you play with a guy on your line or a defense partner, you're going to have much more familiarity with the reads, but the way they play their system and the way they play as a team, it shouldn't really bother them that much.
Marc-Andre Bergeron, long drive, handled by Lundqvist. Jeff Wojtka for the pass. It comes around off the stick of Marc-Andre Bergeron. Bruno Gervais was already heading back. Couldn't get much on the clear. Cutting it now, John Mitchell shooting, and it's stopped there by Garon. And Mitchell will take it behind the net. Circles out in front. Matched up there with Bergeron. Makes a move for the slot, guides it toward the net where it's taken over by Gervais. And the Lightning skated to center. Brett Conley with speed down that right side, shooting. And it's off the shoulder of Lundqvist, deflects out of play.
That's something I'd see. He'll probably figure that out a little bit more as he gains more experience in this league, is Conley, as he just used that size and strength and just go right to the net. Take a look at here. You see the speed for the Rangers, especially on this line. Mitchell really holding on to it as everything kind of opened up, and that shot was taken. Garon making the save, but everybody kind of went for the pass, and Mitchell just walked right in and got the good chance away.
Chief, what's important for the Lightning to stress early in this hockey game without St. Louis, a spiritual leader as well as obviously one of the best players on the ice?
You know what, I think so. There's tendency sometimes when you're struggling to get a little bit too fancy, or maybe you try to overpass. You just got to keep it really simple. You just get it right down to the bare bones. And I think they were going to do that even with Marty in the lineup, because, you know, when you're struggling to score goals, the Lightning haven't scored more than two goals in six games coming into the night.
Steve Steve Dowdy checked by Callahan, responds with a hit of his own. In for the point is Dan Girardi, finds Brad Richards. Richards has Fedotenko in front, as well as Callahan, goes to the point to McDonough. He'll feed it down the boards. Here comes Girardi down those boards, matched up with Stamkos. Steve Dowdy over for the puck. Ryan Malone rounds out this line for the Lightning. Victor Hedman paired with Eric Brewer. They're going to see a lot of the Richards line, we would imagine. Although the Rangers, really the strength has been, as Chief noted, Gabrick on one line and Richards on another. They've had a couple of lines going and now finding some support scoring from a third line. Out comes Gilroy for the Lightning on the rush with Dana Tyrell down the off-wing side. He's lined up by Woy Witka. Brandon Prust is checked by Adam Hall. Brandon Dubinsky stopped in his tracks there by Brett Clark. Good pass to Tyrell, has an open shot, and Lundqvist, who makes the save. He's contacted, involved in a collision as Blair Jones was driving the net. And he was involved with a Ranger defenseman. They collided with Lundqvist, who is down, and we've got a penalty call, I believe, here on this play.
I think they're going to give it to the Lightning player for goalie interference. As you watch, nice play by Clark to step up, take the pass, and watch as Clark goes in there. He's trying to stop, but he hit his head on the mask of Lundqvist. And the Lightning will be shorthanded for the first time as Jones has to go and get some medical treatment. But watch as he goes in there. He's trying to stop, doesn't quite do so. His face hits the mask of Lundqvist, and he'll pick up a goalie interference call on it.
When it rains, it pours. He's being attended to by assistant medical trainer Mike Poirier, who, of course, takes the reins tonight with Tommy Mulligan at the hospital, along with Marty St. Louis. So Mike's going to be very busy. Brett Connolly serving that minor penalty for the injured Blair Jones. Jonesy 4 points in 5 games with the Norfolk Admirals. In the time he's been down, this is his 11th game in the Lightning lineup this year. He's had one assist. Now the Lightning off to a good start in killing this Ranger power play, which is operating at 25% the last 6 games. Brad Richards chips it off the boards. Eric Brewer gets to it for the Lightning. Had his stick tied up, couldn't get it out. Derek Stepan for the point. And it bounced off the glass, came right to Garon, and it's fired off Stepan. He'll have to take it at center. Rangers with 1:18 left in this Toyota power play chance.
That's what happened, too. They had Richards at the point on the power play. It wasn't going quite as well as they expected. They moved Stepan back and put Richards up where Stepan usually is, down low, and their power play has worked extremely well since then.
Richards chased by Tyrell, back to the corner, out to the point to Delzato. Delzato gets the pass, over for Richards. He fires, saved by Garon, and a tip by Callahan. He reaches for the rebound. Richards shoots. It's knocked down in front by Pyatt. And Pyatt busts it out for the Lightning. And he'll force Lundqvist to make a stop. 38 seconds left on the goalie interference call to Blair Jones, being served by Connolly. Out comes Gabrick, galloping through center, stood up there by Adam Hall. Hall, a former Ranger, will send his former team back. Anton Strahlman, number 32, inserted in the lineup with the injury to Sauer. Playing his second game with the Rangers, and Tortorella said he was going to see some power play time. Boyle's stick explodes as he plays the puck in deep. Brett Clark with a puck, and he'll lift it down the ice.
Yeah, Strahlman went to training camp with the New Jersey Devils. Didn't make the team, and then sat out until the Rangers signed him at the very start of the year.
Here's Gabrick, stick handling through, finally relieved of the puck. Ryan Shannon gets it out ahead for Vinny LeCavalier. Connolly out of the box, gets the pass, cuts in on goal, and he backhands it wide. Dubinsky moving it to Boyle. Shannon hustling back to get position on his former college teammate at Boston College. Turning the net, it's Victor Hedman. Angles it off the boards ahead for Teddy Purcell. Backhands behind the net. LeCavalier shrugs off a check. Centers in front, lifted away by Fedotenko, his former linemate. Racing for the Lightning bench was Bruno Gervais to try to hold that play in. Eminger gave it up to Teddy Purcell. Eminger scrambles to get the puck back again. Down goes Fedotenko, taken down by Downey. He's going to get whistled for tripping at 6:36. No score in this game, but a couple of close calls for the Lightning. This one for Brett Conley.
Touch the Tampa Bay Lightning with an inspiring touch behind the Lightning bench. Marty St. Louis sticks, which he had prepared for this to be his 500th consecutive game, brought on by the
As we look at Blair Jones, we saw Marty St. Louis sticks in the rack, but he is not here to use them. Blair Jones called up from Norfolk, and interesting, Chief, the Admirals had just arrived in Binghamton. He got into a cab 9:30 this morning and took a cab to New York City. Imagine what that was like, getting into the cab. Where are we going, buddy? Madison Square Garden. Here's a save by Garon, and the rebound ends up in the corner as Stepan let that shot go through a crowd. $500 fare on that cab, by the way.
Would you tip 20% on that fare?
I'm sure Jonesy did. He's a good tipper, from what I understand. Richards gave it up. Out comes Dominic Moore. Occupies the puck. A couple of seconds longer. Finally has to surrender it. Stepan now will be pressured by Pyatt. 1:17 remaining on the penalty to Downey for tripping. Delzato lugs it in. First round pick of the Rangers. 20th overall, the year that the Lightning selected Stamkos first overall. They're old buddies, in case you didn't know. Old buddies. Back when they were 10 or 12 years old. Ah, the stories they could tell. Here's Richards into the zone, dropping it off for Callahan. He shoots, he scores! Ryan Callahan, the Ranger captain, opens the scoring with a power play goal.
That one hurts. Garon was making a number of big saves, really doing a great job. This one from down low finds the five hole. And Callahan picks up number 11 on the year on the power play to give the Rangers a 1-0 lead here. 7:49 will be the time of that 11th goal by the Ranger captain. Very innocent play. But nonetheless, the Rangers have the 1-0 lead.
Jeff Wojtka for the Rangers, paired with Emminger, his usual partner until the injury to Sauer. That puck deflects Rangers into the New York bench.
Sometimes that can be, you know, the Lightning are struggling to score. As we pointed out, Rick, it's been six straight games where they haven't been able to score over two goals on the road. And then you get down early there, you know, it'll be interesting to see how they react to it. And a couple of games past, they haven't responded real well, but that was the big message today from the coaching staff. You must be much tougher on that. You must really get back and start playing harder when that happens. And we'll see if that helps.
Richards and Stepan get the assists on the goal by Callahan at 7:49. Five of his 11 goals have come with a man advantage. He's the team leader as far as those power play goals are concerned.
Well, they've had six shots on goal, the Rangers. Five of them have come when they've had the man advantage.
Puck deflected in by Mitchell. Gervais around for Vinny LeCavalier. And it bounced off Stroman's stick. Taken now by Pyatt. Pyatt will take on Delzato. Curls it in front. Lundqvist with a stick already extended. Stopped that pass and covers the puck. Let's have a look at our Coors Light cold hard fact.
Well, we have a couple of players entering in tonight's game with active point streaks. Brad Richards with that assist now is up his consecutive game streak to 7. Stamkos continued his against the Islanders on Thursday night when he picked up an assist to keep it at 8 points. It's the longest in the current streak that is in the league right now.
Edmund back for it. Long pass for Stamkos, deflects it in. Lundqvist wants to play it in the trapezoid. Rangers move it to Anisimov, who has now become more comfortable playing the left wing, a natural center, picking up the puck. Stepan shooting, and it's blocked by Hedman. Down he goes. Puck to center ice. Anisimov had it poked away by Malone. Rangers relay it beyond the reach of Anisimov. Brewer checks the traffic from each way and is helped out by Brett Clark. Connolly to center. He showed good jump here in the early minutes of this game. Dropping it off for Stamkos. Back for Connolly. Gavrik in for the puck for the Rangers. He'll flip it out to center ice. Clark with it. We're near the midway point of period number one. Rangers leading on a power play goal. The shot 6-4 New York. Here's Stamkos on a steal. Walks in, goes back, and he's forced wide by McDonough. Stamkos on top of the puck, getting to his skates. Rangers take it away. Out comes Sean Avery. He'll angle it to the corner. Brandon Prust with speed already in there, and he's battling Tyrell down the boards. We're going to get a call here for tripping to Dana Tyrell. Three penalties to the Lightning in the first 10 minutes of this opening period.
This guy called it from the Ranger blue line is when this guy called the penalty. From the Ranger blue line. .951 will be the time of it. 1-for-3 on the power play already.
Now, we didn't have a power play opportunity until well into the third period, about 7 minutes remaining in regulation time in the game on Saturday night with New York. And the Rangers ended up with two opportunities, the Lightning one. But we've had three for the Rangers here in the first 9 minutes and 51 seconds with the start of this one. Delzato picks up the puck. Lightning have out there Hall and Moore in front of Brewer and Hedman on the penalty kill. Richards trying to spring Callahan, who got in behind the defense. He'll pick it up off the end boards. Now trying to center. That's blocked by Brewer. Race on for the puck. Delzato from the point. Hall racing to get to those boards. Rangers hang on to it. Richards fakes the shot. Delzato with it. Passes through to the corner. And Hall gets to it ahead of Stepan, but it's held in. Now Hedman chops it free and back to center ice.
You can bet you're going to see 77 and 2 out there a lot tonight. They'll be close to 30 minutes tonight.
Lightning have tomorrow off, then visit the Flyers at the Wells Fargo Center on Saturday night before they return home to host the Devils and the Calgary Flames next week. With the puck, it's Gabrick with speed. Anisimov down the off-wing side. Centers right through the goal mouth. Nobody home. Pyatt got it loose along the boards. And it comes out to Ryan Shannon. Shannon making his play to Gervais. Shannon gets it back again. Draws the attention of Strawman, who's played in the NHL at Toronto, who drafted him, and the Columbus Blue Jackets. Gabrick into that zone to Anisimov, and it's taken away by Shannon. Backhanded down the ice with 20 seconds to go on the penalty. Stamkos getting a shift here,
yeah,
Chief.
Yeah, really good energy on the penalty kill for the Lightning. I think they're getting a little upset. Get a play with some anger sometimes in this game. That helps you.
McDonough feeds one through. It ends up on goal, and Garon with a save. 2 seconds remaining on the penalty to Tyrell as we look at the Lightning's road ahead. Brought to you by Toyota.
As you mentioned, Rick, the Lightning will head up to, or actually down to Philadelphia for that game on Saturday night. Then they'll be home for two, the only two before the Christmas break. The Devils and Calgary come into town. Then they'll be off to Columbus, San Jose, and then Colorado on the 23rd, just before the break, the Christmas break.
You're spending the holidays in Aspen, aren't you?
Yeah.
With your chalet there?
Yeah. Beaver Creek.
There you go. Tyrell out of the box. Lightning kill the penalty. Here's a shot by Benatenko. A save by Garon. Prust in behind for Mitchell. Outfoxed by Bergeron. Nice play to the waiting Ryan Malone. He stopped in his tracks by McDonough. Stamkos hands it off to Downey. Knocked down by Girardi. LeCavalier cruising in for the puck. Meets up with Girardi. Has to break free of the hold from Dan Girardi. Turns, fires toward the net. Saved there by Lundqvist. Centered. It was blocked by Lundqvist. Puck's on the net. And play is halted. As those nets now a little looser back there. The Rangers with a goal by Callahan. One of three in the power play.
Ryan Callahan with our only goal on a night in which Tampa Bay is pressing on without its injured star and Marty St. Louis. You saw his sticks that the equipment staff placed behind there. Marty had prepared those for what was to be his 500th consecutive game for the Bolts. The man replacing him in the lineup, you were talking about it earlier, Rick and Bobby and Blair Jones. Last night at midnight, he was in Norfolk. A 9.5-hour bus ride to Binghamton. They couldn't check into the hotel. Finally, he gets a call at midday that they need him here to replace Marty. They can't find a flight nor a town car. They ask him to hail a cab. The cab driver says, do you mind if I bring my wife along? He said, no. So for 3.5 hours, they drive, as you said, to Madison Square Garden. He pays the $500 tab. He did not know until he arrived here that he has another bus ride in his immediate future, and that is to Philadelphia tonight. And he also has a bloody nose no good deed goes unpunished for showing up here and driving 12 hours to get here.
Wow, amazing story there for Blair Jones as he hopes it pays off in a Lightning victory tonight, and hopefully he's got a hand in it. Puck knocked down and it's chipped by the Rangers out of the zone. Bergeron over four. Conley guides it across. Now Hagelin pulls down Purcell. What is going on here?
Vinny LeCavalier was absolutely hooked down the offensive zone. We saw that in the neutral zone. I don't know. Makes you wonder.
Gilroy checked by Fedotenko. Strawman backhands it in. Garon over for it, leaving it for Gilroy. Plays it now to Clark. Ahead for Downey. Downey leaving it for Shannon, cuts to the net. The pass doesn't make it through. McDonough blocked that, and Richards will take it from there. Out ahead for Callahan. Going to duck inside along with Girardi joining the rush. Callahan fires, and it's tipped away off Gilroy. Puck is played by Shannon off Richards. It ends up out of play in those new seats down near the glass. As Steven Stamkos and the Lightning trying to come back from a 1-0 deficit under 6 minutes to go in this opening period. Before the game, Paul asked head coach Guy Boucher to put into words his thoughts on the impact of the loss of not only Marty St. Louis, but Nate Thompson to the Lightning lineup.
Usually, I would say, it's devastating, and it's, it's probably the worst thing could happen to this team. And it is, but the reality is we have a game tonight, we got to get ready. And what it means is that we've lost the character, not just with him, but there's Thompson that's out too. And Thompson's a very, very much a character guy. So, Marty's everything. And Thomas represents, what we're trying to do here also. And so, losing these two character guys, means devastating blows, but it also means opportunities for some of the guys.
The play resumes with Dominic Moore trying to pressure the Ranger defense. Delzato back for the puck. Around for Avery. Angles it to the corner. Bergeron challenged in there by Brandon Dubinsky. Pressed with it. His pass deflected, reaching Avery. His shot was blocked by Bruno Gervais. Pass out for Blair Jones. Jones will slide it in. Jones turns away from the hit from Delzato. Down he goes as the Rangers push it out to center ice. Eric Brewer has it with about 5 minutes to go in this opening period. Hedman zips the pass to the Ranger line. Knocked down there. It's taken back by Hedman. In for LeCavalier. It's onside, but the play is spoiled at the Ranger defense. Brewer over for Hedman. Anisimov. Wouldn't let Pyatt proceed with it. Anisimov with it. Now to Gabrick. Trying to sprint into that zone. Relieved of the puck by Clark, who knows him well from the Western Conference. Vinny LeCavalier cuts to the middle, looking for room to shoot. He does. A stick save by Lundqvist. Anisimov. Out on the wing for Gabrick. Clark is back. Step on with him. Gabrick trying to tuck it off. He's stopped by Garon. Out in front of Anisimov. Forced behind the net by Purcell. Anisimov gets it back from Stepan. Purcell trailing him. Here's the shot. It missed the net by McDetta. Girardi holding it in. Pyatt getting to it. He'll send it out.
This is the one thing that if you can make the Rangers play in their zone for stretches at a time, you're going to get some good chances. They're very, very good on their on the offense's end of it because they play that very pressure style, as we well know. But you can make them play in their zone, then they'll really start to collapse in front of their goaltender. Hopefully, you can get some screens and deflections on them.
Benetenko in the slot, double teamed. Puck loose, and Pyatt will bounce it back down the ice. Rangers will have to play it. And Girardi sees he's got his partner McDonough with him. And racing in there from the bench for the Lightning is Shannon. He got derailed by Girardi. Down he spilled in a collision with Benetenko away for the puck. Benetenko with it. Moving it out to Callahan. Hedman gets to it on a quick stop. He loses Callahan. Encounters Benetenko. Benetenko strong on that puck. Now to Callahan. Benetenko gets it from Richards. He's checked by Shannon. Regained though by Richards. Callahan matched up with Hedman. Rangers continue to operate below that goal line in the Lightning zone. Richards out in the slot. Benetenko shooting. It's blocked by Shannon. Boy, it's plays like that, Chief, that can help you get out of it when you're under man.
Yeah, you really got to make sure that you do all those little things. You got to start closing guys off on the wall though a little bit more often. Keep letting them play with that puck in there, then you get tired out as well. But close them off, they can't make those plays. Well, let's take a look at our inside look, brought to you by Toyota. You're taking a look at one of the best goalies in the league. And when you take a look at goaltenders, his name comes up quite often. You can see why. Since the 05-06 season, this is where he is ranked as far as all those categories are concerned. His goals against average is first. His shutouts are second with 37 of them. Look at that. Everything in the top five there. Henrik Lundqvist is one of the premier netminders in this league.
Seventh round pick in 2000. He was 205th taken that year, and obviously started playing the NHL coming out of the lockout and started piling up those numbers. Three times he's been a Vezina Trophy finalist. Puck is placed in that zone by Bergeron. Puck's on the net. As we were talking, the mesh is a little looser now because we can recall in years past where it's been very taut. Pucks are in and out of that net very quickly, sometimes too quickly to judge by the officials and everybody in the building. Now Dan Lacroix, Lightning assistant coach, will join Paul outside the Lightning room. We'll get a view from the top. Steve Yzerman in the house, and Paul will visit with the Lightning general manager. Chief on the highlights. We'll have stats as well. But now they've loosened up that netting a little bit. The way it was before in the old days, Chief, it was very loose, and you had a lot of pucks that would get stuck on the mesh. They don't want those stoppages if they can avoid it.
But also then, when you tighten up the nets, then all of a sudden you have to review the goals because they come in and out of the net much faster as well. Here, they have a tendency to stay in the net once it does cross the goal line and get in there.
Sometimes to make sure they're loose enough, you get an attendant who will stand in the back of the net to stretch that netting out. Here's Pyatt trying to center. It's blocked by Eminger. From the point, Gilroy shooting and a blocker save by Lundqvist. The puck knocked down. Lightning have it. They look for LeCavalier in the slot. Collapsing there was Anisimov. Back for Eminger. He's checked by Purcell. Puck deflected out of the zone by Gavrik and a quick move trying to lose Clark. Anisimov dropping it off. Here's a shot by Stepan and a save by Garon as it was tipped in front. He appeared to get his right leg pad on it. Anisimov in the corner. Gavrik out in front. Backhands to the slot. Tricky pass. Pyatt had his stick down. Gilroy to center. A minute to go here in the opening period. Downey on the forecheck in there. Victor Hedman will hold the play in the attacking zone. Sends it across. Stamkos scuffs the one-timer. Downey controls centers, and it's just by Stamkos' stick. Play kept alive for Hedman. Ooh. Trying to find Stamkos, and Benetenko stole that. Callahan lets the shot go. Turned aside by Garon. Benetenko circles with it. Ryan Malone off the boards. He'll play it back to center ice. McDonough checked by Downey. It's tapped ahead to Fedotenko. He's rocked on the hit by Malone. Callahan winds, fires. That was snuffed out and covered now by Garand with 19.9 to play in the period.
Well, you could just see so at certain times this team is very, very fragile as far as their confidence is concerned. And, you know, when they get that puck going in the offensive zone, they seem to get a little bit more jump. But the Rangers, once they've gotten in the offensive zone or the Lightning's defensive zone, whatever the case may be, they've been able to control the play much more. Zone time has been favoring the Rangers. It's Lightning need a big play or something really good to happen for them to get some more confidence in their game.
Off the faceoff, Prust with a try, and it ends up on Garand, who will hang on to it. 12.1 to play. Shots 12-7 Rangers. Boyle checks the time.
One of the things when you lose the puck, you've got to work twice as hard to get it back. That's something that they have done on a consistent basis either. When you lose the puck, they'll stand and look at it instead of just really getting after the puck again.
Hall wins the faceoff, but stepping in there to get a shot on goal was Dubinsky, who's been held to just one goal in 24 games so far this year. Rangers trying to move that puck battle off the boards. Can't do it before the buzzer sounds. Ending the first 20 minutes of play, the shot's 12-7 Rangers. The goal by Callahan, but the Lightning, their mission to hang in there and perhaps can strike later on as they're undermanned without St. Louis, without Thompson, without Kabina, without Oland. They're trying to get the job done to end a five-game losing streak here in New York. Welcome back to the Buick GMC intermission report. The Lightning trailing the Rangers 1-0. Great look at the Brooklyn Bridge as Callahan on the power play, one of three first period power play opportunities for the Rangers. The only goal so far as we have a look at the highlights with Chief, brought to you by your local Buick dealer.
Well, we're going to see a number of pretty good saves for the Lightning, especially for Matthew Garand on the power play. They had to kill off three. One, you see the thing, this is what you got to look at, right? Look at here. Everything down here is all closed off. That's the key thing as far as the puck gets down low. The Lightning do a good job. They jam it in there. See Matthew Garand making sure it gets down there. The Lightning do a good job as well. And this shot will come in and they'll block it. You see it right there kicked away by the defenseman's skate and it moved out of trouble. Actually, that was Tommy Pyatt's skate that he kicked it and got out of there and got it out of trouble. So they did a pretty good job, but most on the power play chances that the Rangers had. They had three of them. But this was the goal that they got, and it seemed like a very innocent play, as you well know. But Richards is so good at getting the puck in the zone, and you see him maneuvering it around, just moves it over. Everybody's got him off now. He's going to stop it here. You see, here's the circle. Every player wants the puck, or goalie wants the guy to be on this side of the puck and down or circle and down low from that circle, because those are the easiest shots to handle. This time, Callahan takes the quick shot, and Garand doesn't get the hole between the legs close quickly enough, and that's the goal by the Ranger captain, his 11th of the year on the power play. But here's something, too, that you might want to put in the back of your mind. This is a very innocent play. Watch how LeCavier walks across the center of the ice. Doesn't look like it's too much, but if we stop it here, look at how deep he is. There's the goal crease. It's going to go right out here. And look at how deep he is in there. If you can get that shot away, this one's not a real hard shot. He just kind of gets away from his body but slides it. Look at Lindquist, how deep he is in his net. He had to really make a quick left pad save. If you can get across and make that happen when you have any kind of a steam on the shot and a little bit of the height on it, you could score some goals on this guy.
We look at the numbers brought to you by Buick. 13-7. They added a shot, the intermission for the Rangers there. As the scoring chance is a little more equitable, the power play opportunities certainly were not. And the Lightning with 16 hits, I think they'd actually like to see that number come down. That would indicate they'd have the puck a little more often, but nevertheless, 10 players participating in those 16 hits. Our Ottawa poll question, what should the name be for the Lightning's new conference? How about TB1, Snowbird Conference, TB2, Andrechuk Conference, played with four of the seven teams. TB3, North by Southeast Conference, TB4, Other, Twitter 2, at Sun Sports Bolts. Text your choice to 789-789. We'll have the results after the game on Lightning Live. And Chief, what was your suggestion?
I'm not getting into it.
Okay, okay. had something to do with traveling.
No? Yeah, Gulliver travel. That's the Gulliver system.
In any case, it's shot in by Emminger. Anisimov in the corner, met by Brewer, who played nearly 10 minutes in that first period, as Chief indicated. We're going to see a lot of Brewer and Hedman, and that's good news for the Lightning, as Hedman over 9 minutes himself. Over 3 minutes for each one of those players had to do with killing penalties. The Lightning shorthanded for over 5 minutes of that first period. As the pass around for LeCavalier, sending it through center. Delzato has to turn and chase with Emminger. Moved on from the Lightning to Anaheim and then now to the Rangers. And the Rangers held up at the line, but Anisimov got it back from Pyatt.
Didn't look like that puck got completely over that blue line before those two Rangers were in there fast.
Stamkos trying to get to the puck. Flicked away by Emminger. Stamkos in that corner with Steve Downey. Brett Clark at the point, wanting shooting, and it deflected over the net. Lundqvist lost track of it after it tipped. And it was a control with a high stick by the Rangers. We get the whistle. Lightning back home next Monday, taking on Marty Brodeur and the Devils at 7 o'clock. Special starting time there at the St. Pete Times Forum. Great seats are available, 800-745-3000, or visit Ticketmaster.com for tickets.
Well, it says the Lightning must have got the high stick as the play comes out of the zone. It's hard to follow now these calls, Rick.
I think that that shot that deflected might have clipped off the netting, and they ruled that it went off a Lightning stick.
I think that might have been the case as well.
Puck set in. Avery bumped by Stamkos. Checked by Callahan. Richards ducks it behind the net, and there's a shot, a save by Garon on Fedotenko, and he makes a stop there up near the mask. Hedman up the boards, bounces for Stamkos. Steven will push it to the corner. Lightning will change it up. Sliding in there was Ryan Malone getting it in front. It's taken away by McDonough. Callahan will ease it into the zone. Rangers will change. Bergeron back four. Long pass is Conley curling back to take it at center. He's matched up with Strahlman.
Those stretch passes they worked on a lot in the morning skate. With the Lightning getting back, they want their defense back quickly, and then it's firing them up quickly as well to get to the Lightning and get in the Ranger zone as fast as they can.
More pushing and shoving with Roy Witka as Gervais bounced one in on Lundqvist. Dominic Moore, one of a host of former Rangers on the Lightning squad. He and Brett Conley talk things over this upcoming faceoff.
Yeah, there's a number of players that have played with the other team. You know, the Rangers have Emminger, Richards, Fedotenko. You have Moore, Hall, Gilroy. The way the free agency is now, it's very rare to see that. You don't see too many guys like a Marty St. Louis that plays his whole career, or Vinny LeCavalier with one team, Jerome McGinley. You don't see that very often. I don't think you see very much of it anymore either.
Puck chopped away by Roy Witka, and it's taken by Mitchell. Walks in, had it stolen from behind by Conley, and he chips it into the Ranger bench. Another former member of the Lightning organization, Mike Sullivan over there as assistant coach to John Tortorella.
Yeah, that's really a nice thing when you see you get back that back pressure. There's Sully, he's a coach, head coach in Boston a couple of years, and then very, very sharp hockey mind, Mike Sullivan.
Probably gets that from all the wings he used to eat.
Yeah,
Patrick wing guy.
Yeah, Patrick wings.
Dubinsky out of the corner, trying to march in front. Prevented from doing so by Brett Clark. Lightning come up with it. Gilroy trying to slip it out. Eventually they do work at the center. Avery waits for the zone to clear and fires it back in. Brandon Press will pick it up. Avery takes a look out in front. Couldn't get the puck to cooperate. Met there by Gilroy. Avery goes down. Still able to move that puck to Prust. He's pinned by Clark. Gilroy takes it. Blair Jones collided early in the game with Henrik Lundqvist, incurred a goaltending interference penalty, but his head hit Lundqvist's mask and injured his nose. But has continued after a brief respite. Anisimov busts away from a couple of Lightning forecheckers to center. Prest's pass knocked down by Pyatt. It's backhanded in by Strahlman. Garon was out to play the puck, but Anisimov complicated things. Pyatt to center. Meets up with Emminger. Stepan is checked in there by Purcell. Long pass out for Marian Gaborik. Victor Hedman using his reach to force him wide. The puck was left. Brewer came across to keep it out of the hands of Stepan. Lightning used the glass to get it to Pyatt, and he clears it out.
Well, they're doing a better job in the early part of this period of getting the puck out of their zone quickly. Now they just have to add to that where they can keep it in the Ranger zone a little bit more often and for longer stretches of time.
Well, as Dan Lacroix told Paul at the intermission, Ranger forwards are very good at possessing that puck, and that's been something that the Lightning haven't been real consistent with this year. At times they've been very good, at other times they've needed to do it more.
Yeah, poise and patience when the offensive zone is such a factor, because if you can hang on to it and then make the play, it's much better than just getting in there and just throwing it away blindly and trying to increase the speed of the play. So
Girardi feeding it back. Rangers in transition. Callahan dropping it off. Richards with his try tipped by Gervais. It comes down to Fedotenko in the corner. Taken away by Bergeron. The Lightning move it out. Malone handing it to Downey. He'll bounce it to the corner. And Stamkos with his speed in there ahead of Girardi. Girardi got it loose around to Fedotenko. Pressured there by Gilroy. And Clark comes across. Girardi taps it back into the Rangers attacking zone. Richards is felled by Clark. Puck loose behind the net. Malone reaching for it. Clark in there as well. And Malone pulls it back to Gilroy. And the Lightning move it out with Ryan Malone up the middle. Continues to the line. Backed up. Stamkos with a little room. Closing in with McDonough. Gilroy looking for a chance to shoot. He does. Save by Lundqvist. He stopped the rebound. Try by Downey. And the Lightning get it back. Gilroy. Now to Brewer, firing off the end boards. It came out in front. The Rangers were able to clear it away. Callahan looking to desperately get it out. And certainly the best pressure in a while for the Lightning.
All set up by Matt Gilroy, moving up on that play quickly.
Janet got tangled up, and we're going to get a call against the Rangers here. It'll be the first one against New York. When they control, and Boyle does and gets a shoulder into Brewer in doing so, it looks like the Lightning will go to the power play for the first time tonight, down 1-0.
Carl Hagelin in the box. The Bolts set to go on the power play, trailing by a goal. We play inside tonight in 3 weeks. One of the great treasures of the National Hockey League, the Bridgestone Winter Classic, will be played in Philadelphia, Citizens Bank Park, featuring the next two opponents, the Tampa Bay Lightning, the Flyers that they'll see Saturday, and these New York Rangers who debuted in Central Park, the sweater that they will wear. Think along the lines of 1926. That was the year, the very first season of the New York Rangers, and their original emblem will be on the chest as they skate on January 2nd in Philadelphia. And 24/7, the Emmy Award-winning documentary acclaimed on HBO, Rick and Chief already underway in production. That great behind-the-scenes look at the National Hockey League that will feature the Rangers, the Flyers, and they're here tonight, so the Bolts are going to be a part of that show as well.
Thanks, Paul. As the Lightning embark on this Toyota power play chance, their first one of the game, Steven Stamkos trying to bring that puck through center. They're at 14.9% on the season. Trying to end a 1-for-15 slump during this losing streak. Bergeron sends it across. Teddy Purcell resting it. It's knocked down in front. Rangers trying to get control. They do. Dubinsky clears. Bergeron.
The key in this power play now is once you do take that shot is your puck retrieval. You've got to work really hard to get that puck back once you lose it.
Malone blocks the clearing attempt by Emminger. Emminger scuffed the second try. Purcell gains control. And a penalty upcoming to the Rangers.
Give it to them.
The late just, call. Yep. Here's a pass across. Stamkos is stopped by Lundqvist. And as he centers, Emminger controls. Will have the penalty called. And it will be Emminger going to the box with 49 seconds to go on the call against Haglund.
Good chance by Stamkos, but you know, when you see that referee's hand up there, you have a chance to go two-man up. Give it to the team right away. Now you have that two-man advantage a lot longer. Here comes that one-timer. Nice low shot, though, as he was at the bottom of the circle. You can see it right here, and then you see it hitting the pad beside the net. But Lightning taking a timeout right here.
Now Guy Boucher realizing the importance of this 5-on-3 without a talent like Marty St. Louis to join this unit. And so he's mapping something out there, a critical moment for the Lightning down 1-0.
Key thing now is to move the puck quickly. If you stand with the puck, you know, you help kill that penalty for that three-man unit out there. They would love to have you just stand around the perimeter. If you can get that puck moving fast, now they have to move a lot as quickly, and the goalie has to move faster as well. That creates more holes.
Now, Vinny, in talking with Paul before the game during the warm-up, said that he thought they might go with getting more pucks at the net on the power play without Marty to help create some openings. We'll see how they approach the 5-on-3. Lightning get the faceoff, and Bergeron with it. Working with Le Cavalier. Stamkos down the boards. Malone stationed in front. Purcell at the opposite circle. Bergeron takes it. Handing it out of Vinny. He'll quickly fire, and he missed the net. Bergeron in position to get the puck once again. Now to Stamkos closing and shooting, and a slotting block made there. And Girardi blocked it, chopped it out of play. And they're going to rule that the puck went out of play off Stamkos's stick. So not only did they avoid a delay of game penalty, but the draw comes to center. 24 seconds to go with the first penalty.
Well, they were moving it a lot better. You saw that kind of a real nice little play where LeCavalier was back, moved into the slot. You get body movement as well as puck movement. Then you get that defensive team really on their heels.
Le Cavalier wins the faceoff. Bergeron easily enters. Kind of a lonesome end on that alignment. Purcell up top for the moment. Stamkos fakes the shot. Bergeron now to Le Cavalier. Bergeron trying to get to Dubinsky out of position. Purcell pulls the trigger and he sends it wide. Didn't get good wood on it. Bergeron now to Stamkos. He fires. Saved by Lundqvist up high. First penalty's over. Haglund having trouble standing up. As Dubinsky carries the puck to center, Haglund was waiting for a moment, backed up and almost fell down. Prost winding, firing, saved by Garon. Puck is left, Dubinsky hops on it. Dubinsky shoots, he's stopped by Garon. And the Lightning gain control with 50 seconds to go in the Emminger call for high sticking. Long pass to Le Cavalier. Over for Stamkos, quickly covered there, muscled by McDonough, able to keep the play alive. The Lightning have touched up in that line change now, and they're onside as they start it in. Brewer, Shannon, shooting, glove by Lundqvist, bobbled at the whistle, blew, and Moore was reacting to that puck actually still being loose, but Rooney had blown the whistle. And play halted, 24 seconds to go in the power play call.
Well, you're going to make sure you get to very quickly. The puck was right there, and then they come in after the play. But you want to make sure that nobody gets to your goaltender. Are they handing out penalties again?
Well, Delzato heading toward the box.
Moore as well.
And that appears to be the case here at 8:53.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are the penalties. Tampa Bay, number 19, Dominic Moore, 2 minutes for slashing.
The Rangers, number 4, Michael Delzato, 2 minutes for roughing. Time of the penalties, 8:53.
Roughing for Delzato, slashing for Moore at 8:53. So now it'll still be a 5-on-4 for the Lightning for 24 seconds.
coincidental minor penalties as the puck cleared down the ice. Not affecting the manpower on the ice as Girardi clears it. Rangers coming in almost 85% in killing penalties.
You got to pass the puck better than that.
And they're close to erasing the first two Lightning opportunities as they overlapped. Out of the box comes Emminger. Brewer shoots it in. Rangers back to full strength. The puck off the boards. And Cudley in front. The shot stopped by Lundqvist. He makes the save on Shannon. A miraculous save there. Set up by Conley, a fortuitous bounce off the Zamboni entrance boards in that corner.
Oh, it looked like the game was tied. He is so good down low and in close. Take a look at this nice play here. It comes right off there, and then he just took a hold of it, make sure he got control of it, and just that hesitation and making sure he had control of the puck allowed Lundqvist to get over.
All digs in for the Lightning on this faceoff. Adam, a 63% man on the draw, but beaten here. Wojtka takes his time. Long pass. Relayed now for Gabrick. He is upended on the hip check by Gilroy. Boy, Gabrick was at such a speed, it wasn't going to take much to upend him, and Gilroy did the number on him. Backhands it in off the glove of Wojtka, retrieved by the Lightning. Here's the shot. It's deflected wide as Tyrell let it go. It's sent over the net by Hedman. Pyatt takes it. He fires a stick save by Lundqvist. Hedman lines it up. He'll shoot. It's deflected by Tyrell off the glass. Gilroy down the boards. Much better period here for the Lightning and pressure.
Yeah, they're getting on the puck much faster. They're winning a lot more of the battles along the wall and in the corner as well.
Drawman was just able to get it away from Tyrell, get it out to center. Blair Jones with it. Jonesy, a couple of moves to play it down the boards. He'll give chase. Meets up with Strawman. Shannon trying to pop it in front, blocked by Wojtka. Callahan escapes. 9:15 to go in the second period. Only goal of the game scored at 7:49 of the first by Callahan on a Ranger power play. It was her second opportunity. Pass ahead for the waiting Gabrick. Mishandles it. Jones with it. He'll backhand to the corner. Shannon trying to get position on Wojtka. Muscled him out of there. And out the center ice comes Strawman. Tipped down the ice. Back on Golden. Garon got it off to the side to Bergeron. Malone backhands it in. Ryan McDonough, the former Canadian, over. First round pick. Gave it up and Malone fires it home. Ryan Malone stole the pass. And he's tied this game at one off the giveaway by McDonough.
They've talked about how much he has played and how well he has played, McDonough. But this one here is an unforced error. And it's a part of our Ottawa replay as you see the quick shot by Malone. You saw him from outside the hash marks. There's that backhand. They're trying to move that puck quickly. Malone just really read that play so well. And that's going to be a welcome goal for Ryan Malone, who has had a goal-scoring slump himself.
One goal in his last nine coming in. He scores here his sixth goal of the year unassisted at 11:23 of the second. And that has quieted the Garden crowd considerably, and the Lightning have put together a pretty good 12 minutes here in this second period. Malone across for Brewer. Out on right wing. Deflected. Stamkos busting away from McDonough. Penalty upcoming here. And we get a hooking call coming up with 8:07 to go in the second period. Ryan Malone scoring for the Lightning to tie the game at one. Let's take a look back at one of the Lightning's memorable performances brought to you by Land Rover. Let's take you back to almost Christmas time last year, Chief.
Yeah, a shootout for the Rangers and for the Lightning that lasted 11 rounds. And both goalies were extremely tough until the final right there. Ryan Malone with that Quick wrist shot, almost the same spot where he just tied the hockey game right now. Ryan Malone ended it on the in the 11th round for a Lightning victory.
Dan Ellison goal for that one. One of four victories for the Lightning in all four meetings against the Rangers last year. They also won by one goal in this building on another occasion, 2-1. It was a shot by Callahan that missed the net. Richards in behind the net for Callahan. Going to step out in front. Nice move. However, LeCavalier ripped it off his stick. Shots now 16 all, so it's 6-3 Lightning in the second period. Or I should say 9-3 Lightning in the second period. On the shot board, Purcell. His pass was knocked down by Dubinsky. Lightning trying to create something here. Forced to center by Callahan. Stamkos gave it up to the defense. It's backhanded down the ice now as McDonough off for hooking at 11:53, a third Lightning power play chance. Purcell cuts into that zone, leaving it back for Stamkos. Spins away for Dubinsky. Pass across for Purcell. They've got Connolly out in front of Lundqvist. The Cavalier down low, trying to outmaneuver Girardi. Still has the puck. One hands it to Bergeron. He'll fire, and it hit Connolly in front. Retrieved by Stamkos. Getting it out of Purcell. 45 seconds to go on the McDonough penalty. Stamkos, the one-timer, and that was blocked in front. It hit Connolly. He's shaken up. Rangers have the puck. Anisimov back, along with Dubinsky. And they pick up the trailer. Delzano, but they score. Anisimov tucked it home with a shorthanded goal, and the Rangers in front 2-1. And we've got a battle brewing out at center. Downey trying to get in the middle of it here. LeCavalier being held out by the linesman as Dubinsky is paired off.
I guess with Downey.
And Downey and Dubinsky starting to go. LeCavalier had been taken out of there by the linesman and put in the Lightning penalty box.
Well, make that Bergeron. I'm sorry, Rick.
Marc-Andre Bergeron. With his jersey pulled up, hard to tell from that scrum who had paired off. But Downey in the middle of it. Purcell as the Lightning power play unit victimized with a shorthanded goal. But Connolly in no position to come back and help defensively. He was hobbling trying to get to the bench. And we've got another one going. And Anisimov gets popped by Stamkos. Downey held off by a linesman. And the other linesman, Roddy, has got Anisimov. And Rooney's got additional penalty calls. So we've got referees pointing like they're New York City traffic cops here, directing traffic in one direction to the penalty box for quite a number of players.
There's celebration of a goal, and then there's rubbing salt in the wound. And that's what I think. We saw that with Ovechkin a year or two ago. And now you see it here. Here, watch this. It's not really a heads-up play by the Lightning. They just kind of stood around as they moved the puck around and Mislav gets it. But watch this. As he's shooting the gun at the goaltender. That's what really upset him. That's when LeCavalier went after him. And you see the goal being scored by him. And then look at this. See this?
No place for that in our sport. We got enough of it in the other sports. Yeah.
And this is what they're after him for, and they're wondering why. And Donnie come after him. Everybody came after him.
Well, LeCavalier with 6:37 to go in the second period coming out of the penalty box. And he's picked up his stick and is heading toward the Lightning bench. And Mikey Poirier, who frequently does do double duty, Chief. I mean, he's in charge in terms of the medical side and obviously very capable of doing that, but he does spend a lot of time helping out the equipment managers and setting up rooms on road trips and things like that. helping out Vinny, who had permission to come out.
No, he doesn't get a penalty. He just threw him in the box. Why that? A linesman did that. Why? And this is what, it's something that this is really going to bring your team together. When you get scored on, you're upset anyway. And you get scored on shorthanded, you're twice as upset. But then you go and you over-celebrate. Let me tell you, they went right after him. They didn't do it when Ovechkin did that with the hot stick a couple years back. This time they did. And for me, that's the thing you have to do, in my mind.
Well, the two guys on that Ranger bench, you can tell just looking at John Tortorella, he's not happy at all that his player was involved in that. Because that's just not how he operates, and that's not how 98% of the National Hockey League operates. And who knows, Chief? I mean, you look at these other sports, you look at football where they throw a flag for excessive celebration. Maybe Brendan Shanahan is probably smacking his forehead saying, no, wait a minute, we're going to have to come up with something now in this sport? I got something else to deal with?
That's the least of what Jenny has to handle. But usually when you explain the penalties to one side more than the other, that's the side that's getting the bulk of the penalties.
Now 31 seconds remaining on the penalty to Ryan McDonagh for hooking. I had looked away, was trying to check the time of that. Of course, they've got everything but an exploding scoreboard here. There's no way you can find the penalty time after a goal's been scored. We know how that works in arenas at this point. And that's when Anisimov tried to fire off a few rounds, and the Lightning responded. Now Stamkos is being escorted into the box.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are the penalties.
Let's take a look at his involvement in this.
Number 47, Marc-Andre
Bergeron. See his Downey's being held off.
4 minutes for roughing.
Number 91, Steven Stamkos. 2 minutes for roughing. Number 9, Steve Downing. 2 minutes for roughing and a 10-minute misconduct. The Rangers, number 17, Brandon Dubinsky.
Well, Bergeron, double minor, Stamkos, and Downey pick up roughing minors, but Downey picks up a misconduct as well.
2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct. A double minor, 4 minutes for roughing, and a 10-minute misconduct.
Now Stamkos with a little shot. You saw the overreaction by Anisimov. Well, Anisimov gets two for unsportsmanlike conduct for the response after the goal. Double minor for roughing and a 10-minute misconduct. Dubinsky, 4 for roughing. On the Lightning side, Stamkos, 2 for roughing. Bergeron, 4 for roughing. Of course, it was he and Dubinsky pairing off away from the crowd. And Downey, 2 for roughing and a 10-minute misconduct, I'm sure, for trying to prolong things. And who knows what's relayed to the players, what's said to them in terms of how far they can go, and if it's time to quit. If you persist after you've been warned, you will get an extra 10 minutes. So we have 5 Lightning skaters on the ice and 3 Ranger skaters. They're already down a man with McDonagh in the box. Boyle and LeCavalier were bent down as if to take a faceoff and were talking to each other. So it looks like the additional penalty to the Rangers here affecting the manpower, and the Lightning look to be getting the 5-on-3 with 6:37 to go in the second period. Anisimov, by the way, did score a shorthanded goal before all of this exploded. At 13:23, his 5th and 1st shorthanded.
Delzato and Dubinsky picked up the assist on that shorthanded goal to give the Rangers back their 1-goal lead at 2-1. They don't have the, well, they did. I was just going to say they finally put the penalty up on the board.
The extra minor being served by Hagelin. And so the Lightning have 25 seconds of another 5-on-3. Clark, Shannon fires, steered wide by Boyle. Shannon works to get it back, keeps the feet moving around to LeCavalier. They've got Malone in front, Shannon and Purcell in that vicinity as well. Here's Vinny from the angle, shoot save by Lundqvist, rebound, Callahan gets it to Boyle. It's clear down the ice. McDonough steps out. It's a 5-on-4 for 128.
That's going to be the key, Rick, is the retrieval. Talked about that.
Pass is taken over by Fedotenko. He'll ease it down the ice as he and Stefan work up front for the Rangers. And it's taken by Clark. Teddy Purcell on the move for the Lightning. Stick handling into the zone. Back for Dominic Moore. Beating it back out to Shannon. Over for Gilroy. LeCavalier trying to set up Purcell in the slot. Didn't get much of the pass, and it's cleared away by McDonough. Shot 17 apiece to this point of the game. A 2-1 Ranger lead as Brewer through center. Lightning trying to tie it up here in the final 35 seconds of this power play chance. Tipped away by McDonough, recovered by Connolly, who's able to come back out there. He was shaken up on the play that led to the shorthanded goal and all the activity afterward. Connolly back for Gilroy. 15 seconds to go. The call being served by Hagelin. Connolly takes it, carries the puck to center. Slams on the brakes. He'll slide it along the boards. In for Pyatt. Wrestled off the play by Delzato. And the Rangers now with Hagelin leaving the box. Brewer took a glance his way to make sure he knew where he was coming from. New York back to full strike. Moore with a shot. Saved by Lundqvist. Covers the puck as Moore followed up. And now we got Delzato, of all people, trying to tangle with Dominic Moore.
You got Wisniewski go and Connolly.
Well, Preston Connolly disengage. Everybody calms down. We'll step aside. Action heating up with the Rangers leading 2-1.
Well, you're taking a look at the youngster, Brett Connolly, as you see the Ranger having this one goal lead. But just prior to that shorthanded goal that gave the Rangers that lead, he had two shots coming from the point, one from Bergeron. You see it hit him right there on the inside of the leg. He wasn't sure exactly where it was. That was the first one. Then this one from Stamkos, and he got it on the outside of the leg. Let me tell you, you got two guys that bring the puck pretty hard, and he got them both on his leg where there was not a whole lot of padding, and you see him getting very, very slow to get up. And that's how the Rangers right after that were able to take the puck, take it the length of the ice, and pick up that lead goal shorthanded by Anisimov, which has created all kinds of action in that penalty box. Is now Dominic Moore and Delzato pick up penalties at the 15:34 mark. Moore for slashing, Delzato for roughing. They picked up those same penalties back at 8:53.
And so we will skate 4-on-4 with 4:26 to go in the second period, where the Lightning have really responded to play a strong period. However, the shorthanded goal by Anisimov has the Rangers in front. Hall and Tyrell, Hedman and Brewer out for the Lightning. Stepan working with Gabrick. Backed up wide by Wojwodka and Strawman for the Rangers. Adam Hall. Tyrell down those boards trying to turn the corner. Shoots deflected. It reached Lundqvist. He made the stop as Wojwodka slowed that shot down. And the Rangers angle it to Gabrick. He's offside.
Well, Tampa Bay Lightning on Sun Sport is brought to you by Hattricks. We talked about one of the best sports, if not the best sports bar in Tampa. You can bet that they put down their chicken wings and beer to be watching all this action that's been going on here in the last 6 or 7 minutes of this second period.
Got hot sauce flying all over the place. Stamkos out for the faceoff, gets tripped up as the Rangers come away with it. Ryan Callahan gets the red line. He's able to flick it inside that Lightning zone. He's on Gilroy. Clark with a pass out for Shannon. Ridden off to the boards on the check by McDonough. Richards cuts in for New York. Keeps it on the boards. Gilroy cuts it off there, meeting up with his old teammate Brian Callahan once again. Lightning control with Shannon taking it. Ahead for Stamkos. Tapped in for Shannon. Ryan on the off-wing side. Going to turn away from Girardi. Hedman back of the point. Brewer leans into one. A pad saved by Lundqvist. Shannon behind the net. Matched up with Girardi. Got it loose to Callahan. Callahan, the six-year man out of Rochester, New York. Cuts to center. And he'll play it in deep.
I'll tell you one thing about Ryan Callahan. He really closes his man off almost 99% of the time. Coaches love that. They don't go too far when he's checking.
Wojtka bothered in there by Purcell. Hedman comes over to play the puck, but it comes out to center across to Brewer. He was backing up. Taken out by Mitchell for New York. Cuts to the middle. He's stripped there. Byatt controls for the Lightning. Sails it across. Purcell trying to get to it. Bumps into Wojtka. Stays on it. Wojtka acquired off waivers from Montreal in early October. Carries the puck into the zone, chipping it to the corner. He'll give chase in there with Clark. Puck left. Mitchell will handle it. The former Leaf player sends it across. Gervais got a stick on it. And Purcell out ahead for Pyatt. Purcell lugs it into Dominic Moore out of the box. His shot is spoiled there by Girardi as the team's back to full strength with 2 minutes to go before the second intermission. Carl Hagelin speeding in there, losing Gervais. Now shooting a save by Guerin. Gervais gets some help from Clark. Dudley over for it. He'll just swat it back through center. Girardi looking for Hagelin. And it comes back to Girardi. Carl Hagelin out of the University of Michigan giving it now to Gavrik. Pried loose from behind by Moore. Malone, who's got the Lightning goal, flips it back to center. Fielded there by Girardi. Clark doesn't waste any time. Gets it out to center ice to Malone. Malone cutting in. Flips it in on goal. Follows up. And it was poked away by Lundqvist. Malone nearly got to it. Step on. Lugs it in for the Rangers, trying to set up for the shot. Stripped by LeCavalier. Then he gets some help from Gilroy. LeCavalier controls, locates Hedman. Under a minute to go in the period. And Hedman lugs it out for the Lightning. Going to slide it through to Stamkos. However, that was broken up by a well-positioned Brandon Prust, who gets the pass, leans on the shot. It's blocked by Hedman. LeCavalier slips back for it. Callahan, though, takes it. Richards chased out of there. Shot for the point. Glove by Matthew Guerin. He'll hang on. 36.8 to play here in the second period. Well, stay tuned for the Buick GMC second intermission report. Ryan Malone visits with Paul Kennedy. We'll take you around the league with the other games on the schedule. Busy Thursday night in the NHL. And Chief on the highlights will have stats as well.
Very good spirited effort by the Lightning in this game thus far. You know, you lose a big player in Marty St. Louis and a real inspirational leader as well. And the Lightning here are really best I've seen them come after it, you know, playing with a little bit of an edge and anger.
Tyrell takes the drop pass, gets the shot on goal, a save by Lundqvist. Richards throws the puck to the open boards. Hall gets there in time to hold it in. The shot was deflected wide and picked up by Boyle. Lightning 14 shots to 6 unofficially in the second period, and that's a pretty accurate barometer, Chief.
It is, and I think one of the reasons why, Rick, is because they've worked harder to get the puck back once they've lost it. I think in this slump that they've had, they, you know, once they've lost the puck, they haven't gotten, you know, put their head down and worked hard to get it back. And tonight they've done that. This is a key thing in getting out of your slump and getting in any offense on you. Is work as hard getting the puck back as you do when you have it.
Le Cavalier wins the faceoff. Bergeron, big drive, and it's deflected over the net by Boyle. It's centered in front. It just tipped by Malone, wide of the goal. Clark fires toward the net. That was blocked. Fedotenko with it, and the buzzer sounds, ending period number two. Head coach Guy Boucher has got to be happy with how his team responded in that second period. They came into the period down 1-0, tied it on the goal by Malone. However, the shorthanded goal by Anisimov has the Rangers in front 2-1 through 40 minutes of play. Tampa Bay Lightning Hockey and Sun Sports is brought to you by Toyota. Moving forward. By Land Rover. And by Steak and Shake. Life needs flavor. Great aerial view of Manhattan. No question they are ready for the holidays here. It's 2-1 Rangers through 40 minutes as we have a look at the highlights with Chief, brought to you by your local GMC dealers.
One of the things the Lightning did real well, this was on in a rush where you see the Lightning have three guys, Rangers get four back, but the key part of it was right here. Matt Gilroy moving up very, very quickly to get the loose puck here. That is such an important part of any kind of pressure you get in the offensive zone, is that defense moving up, and Matt Gilroy did a good job of that. Got a shot on goal, rebound just, well, rolled by Downey, and Gilroy actually ended up getting it again as he kept in on that play, as you see right here. So that's the key thing about pressure in the offensive zone. That defense has to help in coming up quickly, and Matt did that very, very well on that occasion. Now this one here, is we saw the Lightning have a number of power plays, four to be exact in that period. Take a look at this one here. You think you're having trouble putting the puck in that? Watch where Stephen Stamkos goes, boom, right off the coconut. Right here, he goes hit right out after it hits Lundqvist right in the head. There you see it. Those guys play a lot of soccer though, so I don't think they're used to that, taking it on the head. But nonetheless, big shot by Lundqvist, or big shot by Stamkos, Lundqvist saved. Now here's the goal that really started that whole fireworks going. But again, you see the Lightning not really getting back. They're shorthanded. They're kind of coming back slowly. There you see Purcell back here. All three forwards are really back there. Then the quick shot save over here. And bang, it was out. Wide open net. And Anisimov picked up the goal. And then the rifle shot was the one that kicked off all that action after that was over. But that's how we stand now. 2-1 Rangers lead on that shorthanded goal by the Ranger forward.
GMC brings us the updated stats through two periods. The shots 14-6, as we pointed out, favoring the Lightning, and certainly tells the tale of the Lightning in that second period. They get all four of their power plays, 2 5-on-3s, unable to capitalize on that, but they did get the goal by Malone. And what do we say about those hits? They only had three hits after 16 in the first period. They obviously had possession of the puck a lot more. Let's look once again at our Ottawa poll question. What should the name be for the Lightning's new conference? Snowbird Conference, Andrechuk Conference. Andy, after all, played in four of the seven teams that will be in that conference. North by Southeast Conference. Or if you have a suggestion, please submit it to Twitter at Sunsports Bolts. Text your choice to 789-789. We'll have the results of Lightning Live after the game.
How did Andy miss out not playing for Montreal?
Yeah. They'll give the gift of hockey this holiday season. Vinny Holiday 4-packs are on sale now, starting as low as $99. Pick four Lightning games of your choice and get a free Vinny LeCavalier autographed puck. Get your Vinny Holiday 4-pack now by calling 813-301-6600 or visit TampaBayLightning.com/holiday. He wasn't in the holiday mood when that old brouhaha was taking place. As Stamkos will open this third period with Malone. And Tom Pyatt. Brewer and Hedman paired defensively. That puck deflected through center. Lundqvist trying to help out his defense. Girardi moves it up the boards, and it's tipped down the ice. And Brewer back at the other end. Gets to it ahead of Richards. This time we've got an icing called against the Rangers. Lightning, 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 Lightning.
Well, right now, when you take a look, when you're down by one, obviously you got to come with some intensity, you know, to get that equalizer. But the one thing is, you got to make sure that you still play within some kind of a structure and not get a little bit too excited to get that goal back too quickly.
Well, this is right where the Lightning found themselves, kind of reversal of roles in the third period on Saturday, leading 4-1, and the Rangers responded. The Lightning trying to pay them back here in this third period, if they can. Bergeron gets to the puck. He's checked along the end boards by Callahan. That's his eighth hit of the game. Always among the league leaders in that category. Now Clark turns away for the forecheck.
It's not so much that he knocks you out into the third row. He just takes you out of play, closes you out. You can't get back into the play very quickly. And that's the thing that you like to see happen more often.
And it's contagious. Yeah, I mean, you see one guy doing it all the time. It becomes contagious through the lineup. As Le Cavalier absorbed the hit from Dubinsky, down he went. Bergeron checked by Stepan. Bergeron boxed in that corner a little bit. Gabrick in for the puck. And behind to Dubinsky. Centers loose in front. Bergeron got it loose. And we've got a hooking penalty upcoming to the Lightning.
Oh, I'll tell you what. No wonder Tom Pyatt's a little bit puzzled by that.
Unofficially, we have the penalty totals equal to this point of the game, 30 minutes apiece, with all the activity following that lead goal.
137. I guess when he got the puck or the stick on his hands at the end, there is the hooking call. Rangers with two special team goals, a power play goal and a shorthanded goal.
Toyota power play opportunity for the Rangers. They scored that power play goal on their second opportunity. Callahan's 11th from Richards and Stepan at 7:49 of the first period. And they get that puck down low once again. Richards unable to center. Play back to the point. Delzato shooting. It's blocked by Brewer. Hedman hurries after it, backhands up the boards, and the play is forced to center by Hall. Ian Moore peel back and a change with nearly 40 seconds gone to the penalty. Richards through center, in for Delzato. They've got Dubinsky in the slot. Pass mishandled, however, it was saved by Stepan. Getting it down low to Callahan. Back to Stepan. Delzato with his angle taken away by Shannon out there quickly on him. Here's a quick shot taken by Stepan and a save by Matthew Garon. The rebound is cleared off the glass and back to center. 51 seconds to go on the penalty to Tom Pyatt. Rangers lob it in there. Delzato gets to it in the corner. Dubinsky along the boards, back of the point. Richards quickly snaps the wrist shot off, and it's stopped by Hedman. He'll sweep it down the ice. 30 seconds to go on this power play chance. The Rangers fourth. Girardi dropping it off for Gabrick. Gabrick swings in. Girardi sends it across. Benitenko watched here. Strawman giving it back to him. Now the pass down low, skipped off Gabrick's stick. Cut off by Gilroy along the end boards. Rangers hang on to it around to Fedotenko. Gabrick circles in front, looks for the shot. It's blocked as Pyatt joins the play out of the box. Lightning killed a penalty. Keep the score at 2-1 Rangers. Boyle tackled in there by Clark. Gilroy backhands it. As Dominic Moore working along those boards, Clark will try to get things going for the Lightning along with Gilroy. Pass ahead for Stamkos. They'll let it go. Rangers changing. Girardi up the board. Stolen by Connolly. Gets right into the action and ran into the Ranger player Girardi. He's shaken up off that collision.
Girardi came out to hit him and got the worst of it.
Connolly flips it in from the blue line. Handled by Girardi, who's trapped out there for the moment. Eminger stopped by Stamkos. Down he goes. And Girardi feeding it back for Steve Eminger. Pardon me, Mitchell from center. He'll play it off the glass. Giron readies himself to play it. He had to wait for that puck to reach the trapezoid before he can legally touch it. Away comes Conley for the Lightning. Cuts inside on McDonough. On the back check, it's Mitchell stealing the puck. Puck knocked down by Pyatt, and Mitchell regains it. John Mitchell to center, caught up to by Pyatt, still able to chip it in. 5 minutes gone here in this third period, a 2-1 hockey game. Waiting at center, LeCavalier deals it now to Teddy Purcell. Hedman trying to help out, keeping it in the attacking zone, and they do. And LeCavalier checked in the corner. Emminger works against him. Vinny, using his size and strength, keeps the puck moving, but Stepan comes back for it. Punches it up the boards. Here's a shot by Brewer. Missed the net. Pyatt over four. In behind to Purcell. LeCavalier turns to find it. Pyatt has it. Grabbed by Carl Hagelin. He'll rush to center. Slides it to the corner. Stepan in there for it. Muscled by Brewer. Sanders, it's deflected. Giron trying to keep it out of the net. And Rooney waves off that he thought of a goal there. The partisan crowd here at Madison Square Garden thought the Rangers had scored. Pyatt. Ahead for LeCavalier, kept in by Delzato. And LeCavalier digs in against the young defenseman. However, the Rangers hold it in for the moment, forced out by Hedman. And he got away with slapping Hagelin's stick out of his hands. Here's Stepan shooting, and it's deflected over the net by Brewer. Lightning on the rush now with Shannon. Cuts in, he's got Blair Jones with him. There's the pass back for Jones. It's by him, Moore with it. Shooting, and it's tipped just wide by Shannon. Down the boards comes Gilroy. Hands it off to Blair Jones, backhands it, and it's stopped by Lundqvist. Tapped through the slot, Richards gets to it. Richards into that zone. Swings wide, feeding it toward the net, and a save there by Giron as a Lightning stick tipped that shot on its way to the net. Moore circles back.
That's the thing, you've got to close out that forward. Just when Richards there, he just comes in slowly and sets up there. Nobody closed him off, and he was able to get that pass through. When you have your men back, you've got to make sure you close that guy. We talk about gap control consistently. That's what the Lightning had to do on that occasion.
Little misplay by Lundqvist behind his own net. Tyrell in there battling with Ryan Malone. Malone is spilled. Stamkos over to provide some pressure, but the Rangers come up with it. Wojtyla takes his time. Going to slip it to Boyle. Taken over by Gervais. Rink wide pass. A dangerous one there as Boyle gets it in behind the net. Giron trying to be the difference maker with the Lightning outnumbering the Rangers down low. Tyrell leads it ahead for LeCavalier, surrounded by blue shirts. Cuts it on the backhand. Stopped by Lundqvist, and the rebound, it's poked wide. As Stamkos drove the net, it's flipped out through center. Hedman takes it. Curling it back for Pyatt. Lead pass for LeCavalier. Trying to cut it around Girardi. Does so. Forced behind the net. Hangs onto it. Stamkos stationed in front. That try was blocked by Lundqvist. And there's a shot that's knocked down as Hedman let it go. Picked up by Stamkos. Shooting into a crowd. Blocked by Girardi. Away comes Stepan. Trying to get it behind. Hedman could not. Play continues here for quite a spell. The shot is saved by Giron on McDonough. He stopped the centering pass. What a shoulder stop there as Giron took that off the right shoulder. Prust taken down by Hall at center. Puck deflects through center ice. It's tapped back to Brandon Prust. He had to wait for a moment and didn't wait long enough. The Rangers offside, 11:20 to go in a rapidly moving third period. Great opportunity for Vinny LeCavalier and the Lightning here, but they trail 2-1.
Well, you see the time remaining here in the third, and the Rangers up by that one goal, but it looked like they might have had that two-goal cushion on this play. Take a look as the puck is bouncing up. It's our Ottawa replay. They reviewed this play. Watch Teddy Purcell there. The puck is right here. Doesn't completely go over the line on that occasion. It comes back again as he tries to clear it. And it just straddles the line again. So they came very close. First, it was initially hit by a high stick across the right here. You'll see it right here as it'll hit by a high stick. And then it went around, and then it was touched by a Lightning player, which is fine, but it didn't completely go across the goal line, which is fine for the Lightning as well, because it still stays a 2-1 Ranger lead.
Since Purcell was the next to touch it, play did not stop. And you could surmise from that replay that they would have called back the goal had it gone across the line because of the high stick by Haglund. But in any case, we continue at 2-1 Rangers here in the third period. Just over 9 minutes have been played. Play in the Lightning zone. Brewer heads for the corner. Got it ahead to Steve Downey. Ahead for Malone. McDonough back. Sends it up the boards. Knocked down by Downey. Picked up by Fedotenko. Now Gilroy compacts the play. Backed up. Malone shooting it away. Crowd. It's tipped on goal by Downey. A save by Lundqvist. Stamkos has it. Malone lurking in front. Actually tried to send it through to Gilroy, but it was off Malone's stick. Still, the Rangers can't clear. It's chopped by Malone. Back toward the corner. Ryan Malone's been very opportunistic in this game, scoring off a Ranger misplay to tie the game at one at that point in the second period. Be sure to stay tuned after tonight's game for the Lightning Live postgame show presented by Checkers.
Anticipation so much a part of being successful in this game. The goalie has to anticipate where that play is going to go. Your forwards have to anticipate where that play is going to go or get there, and that's what happened on that goal for the Lightning. Malone anticipated that clearing pass out through the middle. He intercepted it and scored the Lightning's lone goal.
Well, following the icing call, Rangers taking their timeout for in-depth coverage of tonight's game. Pick up tomorrow, St. Petersburg Times, the official newspaper of the Tampa Bay Lightning and their fans. And remember, starting January 1st, the Times has a new name, Tampa Bay Times. Call 877-THE-TIMES or visit TampaBay.com. Now the Lightning, Chief, the first period, you knew they had to weather the storm, particularly when they were shorthanded three times, didn't have a power play. And even though they trailed 1-0, probably Garon would like that goal back. They hung in there pretty well and really started to get their game going in the set.
Yeah, they really did, you know, and Matthew Garon has played a very solid game in that in the net for the Lightning. You know, he's had a number of key saves and he's had some help too. Teddy Purcell, we just saw that last play going around the goal line. But nonetheless, it's been a pretty solid effort. It's just a matter of if the Lightning could ever get some goals, I mean, going in for them, then these close games are going to be in their favor.
Lightning chased back to center. Be nice to get some second chance opportunities.
Yeah.
I think that's the aspect as you look at these several games. They've been looking for goals. That's an element they've been missing as they trail 2-1 here in the third.
Here's tonight's Diamond Performance brought to you by Ackerman Jewelers, and it's that goal and that anticipation by Ryan Malone as he came in and just ripped that wrist shot past Lundqvist that tied the game for the Lightning at one at that point. And that is our Ackerman Jewelers Diamond Performance of the game. That was Bugsy's second goal in his last 10 games, so I think he's pretty happy that that thing went in as well.
Number 6 on the season for him, unassisted. Lightning trying to continue to go to work in that Rangers zone. The pass came right through the slot with Purcell there. LeCavalier in the vicinity. And they come back to center to play it. Looking to re-enter here. And Gabrick was able to slide it down the boards. And Bergeron back for it. Hounded in there by Anisimov. Public enemy number one at the watch party right now at Curtis Hickson Park. In for the puck, it's Pyatt, and it's taken away by Stepan. And it's lifted back through center, bouncing puck, chopped away by Gilroy into his own bench.
Do they have a Russian consulate in Tampa?
I don't know.
He goes back to Tampa if they get too upset at Curtis Hickson Park, you'd have to file out of the Russian consulate there before the game.
Attaboy, Chief. Incite something here. International incident.
Exactly.
Gilroy getting to the puck. It's played in by Downey. Girardi coming across. Wrapped up by Malone. Callahan chops at it. And Steve Downey back for Gilroy. Fires ahead for Malone. Lundqvist couldn't control it. Downey gets to it, lets it go. Clark with a shot. It's deflected just wide. It might have hit off Richards. Picked up by Callahan. Clark stands him up with the line. Gilroy over for the puck. Callahan trying to embellish things to get a call. None forthcoming. McDonough looks for his partner, Girardi. Big windup, and that shot deflected away by Stamkos as he was out covering the point. Lead pass for Gilroy, just tapped away by Girardi. And now the Lightning in a change. Here comes Callahan. Delayed penalty upcoming. He shoots it. He missed glove side. And the Lightning will be issued a penalty. Looks like Malone's going off for roughing at 11:54.
Yeah, it is a roughing call. He gave the call, the sign. Lightning making that change, but not really making a good pass or a good play into areas where you could get hurt. There he went, actually went up high on Fedotenko, it looked like. So that's what will give the Rangers their second power play of this period, fifth of the game. At 12:54.
Dominic Moore leans into this faceoff. Going against Boyle. Rangers tap it back of the point. Delzato and Girardi work from that vantage point. Here's the shot by Gabrick. And it's sent wide as Moore gets to it. He'll send it down the ice. Shots 25-24 Lightning to this point. They started out 13-7 Rangers in the first period. Lightning coming on in the second period. Here's a nice play by Hall and stopping that pass. Brewer gets to the puck.
You know, Adam Hall, I know he was sat out two games. We know they wanted to try and get a little bit more offense in there, but every time he's out there, don't you feel a little bit more safer when you have a power play against you?
Very solid in all areas, and even from the offensive standpoint, he hasn't found the back of the net, but he's always one guy who's got that net presence when he's out there.
Yeah, he brings a crowd when he goes to that net.
Now 1 minute down, 1 minute to go on the Malone penalty. Richards, little shake and bake at center. Moore wasn't buying it. Gervais gets to the dump in, an easy clear for the Lightning. Still on the comeback trail, though, and inside 7 minutes to go in the third period. Ryan McDonough to center. The hard around for Callahan. Back for Stepan. Lightning with numbers in that corner. Gervais in there battling. Dana Tyrell by his side. And they're doing a great job in killing time off this Ranger power play with 23 seconds left to run on it. And the Lightning come up with that puck. It's cleared out.
They get off the ice very quickly on that shift. They saw it created that power play for the Rangers when they were making a line change a little slowly.
The shot by Strawman was deflected away, and the puck cleared out of play with 6:10 to go in the third period. 4 seconds remaining on the Ranger power play.
Let's take a look at our Coors Light freeze cam of the night, and it's going to go back in that second period, and we're going to show you that power play opportunity for the Lightning and the shot right off the mask right here of Lundqvist. And again, another shot right there. You see it, and Henrik taking that right off the top of that mask. And that's our Coors Light freeze camp brought to you by Frost Brewed Coors Light.
Malone back on. Brewer double teamed in behind his own net. Lightning killed a penalty. Rangers 1 of 5 of the power play in this game. The Lightning missing on 4 chances, all in the second period, including a couple of 5-on-3s. Prust matched up with Hedman. Malone comes in to decide the issue, takes control. The lead pass for Stamkos. Lightning go for a change. Stamkos joined by Downey. His shot is deflected in behind the net. Stamkos ridden off by McDonough. Out for Prust. Downey in good position there. Fedotenko trying to push it down the ice, having some difficulty doing so. Gilroy and Bergeron come up with it. Here's Stamkos down the middle. Draws the attention of 4 Rangers, gets it through, and shoots, a save by Lundqvist. Stamkos nearly pulled it off.
Well, I'll say that puck just seemed to follow him around until he got that shot away. Let's take a look at our Stay on Your Feet play of the game brought to you by Timberland Pro. And it goes back to that puck that was knocked down by a high stick and then rolled around, and Teddy Purcell doing a really nice job of keeping that puck from going across the goal line. You're going to see it from inside the crease. Look at this puck bouncing there. Here comes Teddy Purcell. It's not completely over, and Purcell gets it. They get knocked at it again. There it is. It's again on. Makes a nice blocker save to begin with. And it's still rolling around. And that's our Timberland play. Stay on Your Feet play of the game brought to you by Timberland Pro.
Tom Pyatt working the boards. I think from that faceoff, keeping it in the Rangers zone. Shannon around for Clark. Richards bats it away, recovered by Shannon, whose speed has been evident in this game tonight. Emminger back up the board. Stepping in front of him was Marc-Andre Bergeron. Getting it to Pyatt. Excellent shift for the Lightning. And Shannon back of the point. What's that shot go? It's blocked in front by Delzato. Wrists it, but not out. Held in by Shannon once again. Pyatt in behind to LeCavalier. He's really dueling with Emminger. Emminger got the puck free. And it's played off the glass by Stepan down the ice. Lightning have to play it. 4:15 to go in the third period.
Still plenty of time.
Now the Lightning, for their last six wins, they have come back from at least one goal deficits to get those victories. Like they had another one here. Stamkos on the move, on the relay, cuts in and shoots. Save Lundqvist, rebound in the slot. It's chipped away, and it's played off the boards and back through center. Malone and McDonough in a big collision. Nabinsky and Downey grabbing each other. McDonough gets up slowly. He was knocked into the boards on that check by Malone. And Rooney is going to call Malone for a penalty. 3:50 remaining in the third.
This is, you know what? He called it. This is the thing is, Rooney's way down by the Lightning top of the circle and calls it as he looks at it. Take a look at this play. This is not one here. They just go into the boat for the puck. It's amazing. How can the guy, off, you know, 60 feet away, 75 feet away, make the call?
And Malone in the box once again, and the faceoff comes back to the Lightning zone. McDonough being checked out.
This is. Makes it really tough. Three power plays now for the Rangers in this period for any kind of a comeback.
Ford digs into this faceoff, pulling it back to Brewer off the glass, support back through center. Delzato picks it up. And Girardi skates it to the red line, bounces it in behind the net. Brewer in after it, off the boards to Hall. Richard Stick got in there, takes the puck away. It's chopped back to the point. Delzato holding it in. Brad Richards, who assisted on the one power play goal the Rangers had that gave them a 1-0 lead. He's forced back to center as he mishandled at the point. Starts it in with a neat backhand feed to Callahan. Throws it across the crease, tapped away by Guerin, and on the move it's Dana Tyrell. Girardi fell down, but Tyrell couldn't get the puck under control.
And past the linesman. Linesman was trying to get out of the way too, and it hit his foot.
Just over a minute remaining on the Malone penalty, but the game time now under 3 minutes for the Lightning down a goal. Gilroy comes up with it. Tom Pyatt to center. Scoots wide. Reaching out with a poke check was McDonough as he's back in action. Callahan, long lead pass, Gavrik behind everybody as the Lightning have to start thinking about a goal at this point of the game, but he couldn't handle the pass. And it's sailed down the ice by Moore and on net. 30 seconds to go on the penalty, 2:18 on the game clock. As it's Boyle from center, around for Gavrik. Brewer behind the net, joined by Hedman. Hedman, good time to look up ice. Moore wants that pass. He gets it. He'll skate it in. He'll take a shot at it. He scores! What a goal! Dominic Moore said, give me the puck. He took it down the ice. He scores a shorthanded goal to tie the game at two.
Oh, boy, I'll tell you what. There's another guy that has to be so relieved to have one go in. But again, tapping that puck at the very end. He, along with Hedman, you see him getting it, and then he just took right off. Rangers kind of guilty of just not playing it real hard. And that one kind of butterflied up over the glove side of Lundqvist. Hedman will get one assist on it. Coming here at 18:03, the Lightning have tied the game on a shorthanded goal of their own.
First one of the year by the Lightning. Their first since Matthias Olin scored one of the Pittsburgh series in the playoffs, and Nate Thompson had their only shorthanded goal in the regular season. Brewer should get the second assist on it. We'll await the official call on the goal, but it's a new hockey game with 1:50 to go in the third period. And Malone now out of the box. And a Lundqvist holding play.
His second of the season, a shorthanded goal scored by number 19, Dominic Moore.
He was tapping that stick on the ice. He knew exactly what he wanted to do in terms of trying to create an opportunity in a situation where they desperately needed a goal. And he made it work. And Hedman and Brewer indeed get the assists on that goal. Stamkos with a shot. That's blocked. He gets it back to the point to Hedman. Resting, and it's off. McDonough came loose in front. Richards got it away. Callahan to center. Minute and a half to go in the third. The Lightning trying to press the issue here. And completely stunned. Gotham City with a great dramatic comeback. They'll take it however it comes if they can pull it off. Hedman. Across to Brewer. Missed on the pass. Lundqvist stays put. Girardi keeps it moving. Pyatt, speaking of keeping moving, he's always in motion. He's grabbed along the boards, joined in there by Stamkos. Under a minute to go in the third period. Girardi turns the net, lobs it out, hoping to hook up with Anisimov off the wing. But it's played back down the ice by Bergeron, coming over Delzato. Eminger sweeps it up the boards, well anticipated by Adam Hall. Dominic Moore working with Hall. Delzato looks up ice. Flips it rink wide for Gabrick. He's matched up with Clark, who's not going to give him much time or room. It's cleared to center. 27 seconds to go in the third, and fired in by Delzato.
You got to play those good players like that. You got to get right on them. You can't give them any time and space.
Well, Moore ended a 24-game goalless streak with that shorthanded goal. As we're down to 11 seconds, Dana Tyrell into that Rangers zone, stopped by Brandon Prust. And the puck played off the glass to center, and that's going to do it. We will head to overtime as the buzzer sounds. A 2-2 hockey game. Dominic Moore rescuing the Lightning with a late shorthanded goal at 18:03 from Hedman and Brewer. OT is next. We head to overtime here on Sun Sports. The Lightning 4-2 in overtime, 3-0 in the 5-minute sudden death variety as we look at our Steak and Shake 3 stars.
Well, you have to go too far. Dominic Moore with that tying goal at 18:03. Ryan Callahan, who had a goal as well, and he's just been a whirling dervish out there for the Rangers. Ryan Malone that got the Lightning back on even skill, and I thought one had one of the stronger games. A big physical presence for Lightning as well is our third star.
The Rangers in OT, 2-3 overall, 1-1 in the extra 5-minute period. The Lightning in the extra 5-minute period have outshot their opponents 25-5 in going 3-0. Brewer had it taken away. Gabrick out in front. It's by Stepan Stick. As, of course, the Lightning end the 5 consecutive losses in regulation by reaching OT and pick up their 25th point The Rangers, their 34th point, and they battle from there. Here come the Rangers. The pass across to Girardi on the one touch. It's left now on the point. The shot, a save by Garano. The rebound. Step by with a try. It's blocked by Brewer. Four Ducks behind the net. Rangers changing. Fresh legs on for the Lightning as well. And Moore trying to bring that puck down the same side, which he scored. Circles in front. Backhands it. It's blocked by Callahan. Richards. Circles back, hounded by his good friend Vinny LeCavalier. Richards into the zone with speed, turns, fires, sends it wide. Callahan back for Richards. Shannon hurries to the corner. Emminger had pinched in. Delzato waiting, walks it in, winds and fires, and it's off the foot of Gilroy, deflected away, comes to center. It was batted out of the reach of LeCavalier there by Emminger. Gilroy from center lobs it in.
Well, that could have been a dangerous play for the Rangers and a good one for the Lightning, but both the players that were out there at the end of their shift, so they had to get off for fresh bodies.
Down goes Dubinsky, still made the play to McDonough. Back to Dubinsky. Pass there by Girardi, tip to the corner, Victor Hedman after it. Shannon starting it out with Downey. Bust behind one New York defender. Cut off by Girardi. Downey throws the hit on McDonough. Shannon on patrol in that attacking zone with a Lightning change up ice. Dubinsky sends it off the glass. Anisimov in on Bergeron in that corner. Brewer outmuscled his man, and Stamkos scampers away with a puck. Downey with him. Stamkos shoot it, and it's blocked by Delzato. Downey picks it up. Had it taken away by Dubinsky and forced back through center. Rangers are able to get a change going. Moore back on for the Lightning.
Yeah.
Hedman working with Bergeron. Across for Moore, has to take it off the boards. Just over 2 minutes to go in sudden death overtime. Moore looks up ice. He stopped in the poke check. Lead for Gavrik by him. Garon got rid of it. Gavrik was home by several lengths, but he couldn't get to it. Here's a shot by Garon. A save by Lundqvist. Curled in front just by Stamkos' stick. He was open. Back come the Rangers. Three on one. Gavrik cutting in. Forced wide and a sprawling play by Hedman. Step on.
What a play by Hedman. Boy, I'll tell you what, he just had everybody back there.
Girardi stopped by Garon. The rebound by Stepan goes to the corner. Walks out of that corner, stripped by Moore. Pass it behind the net. Bouncing over the stick of Gavrik, taken by Gilroy. Stamkos bats it away down the ice. And we'll get an icing call against the Lightning, so they can't change. 1:12 to go in overtime.
Boy, we had some pretty good opportunities. The Lightning get caught with four men on one. You see it coming back, and they throw the puck up, and then here comes the Lightning with a pretty good opportunity. Gilroy making the save. And Lundqvist not controlling the rebound, and the Lightning just couldn't get it into an open spot for one of their old teammates to get that open net.
Hedman. Where's the Lightning without their all-time greatest overtime hero? Marty St. Louis has 18 career points in overtime, including 8 goals, but they're going to work here without him. Under a minute to go in overtime. Great save by Garon there on Callahan, set up by Richards. Richards curling with it. Callahan fires from the angle. Save by Garon. Rebound, another save by Garon and Richards. That shot hit the goalpost by Callahan. It's cleared out by Moore. 36 seconds to go.
They were caught on a long shift because, remember, they had that puck iced and they had to stay out there. Now they finally got fresh bodies out. But
here's Richards shooting, and it's deflected over the net by Clark. Played back to Richards down low. He couldn't center. Still has the puck with 15 seconds to go. The pass reaching the point. That shot kicked out by Garon. As Delzato down low, let it go. 5 seconds to go. LeCavalier swinging in. One last move. Locked up by Girardi. And that's going to do it for overtime. We go to a shootout. Tied at two. Tremendous excitement. A tremendous overtime performance by Mathieu Garon. The shots unofficially through 65 minutes. 31-29 Lightning. Wow. What goaltending.
Well, you're looking at Mathieu Garon trying to regain his thoughts, his focus. But boy, he was focused in the overtime. Look at the save he made off of Callahan, a tremendous save. Then they got another really good shot away on him here. Richards setting it up. Quick shot from the corner, but the rebound off from Richards. That was the three, and then off the post. The Rangers ended up having 5 shots in the overtime to 1 for the Lightning. And Mathieu Garon was perfect in all 5 of them to maintain that. The tie game.
Now the two coaches getting their shootout lineups together. Obviously, Guy has settled on his crew first. Mathieu Garon, by the way, in 2007 and 2008, tied the record for most shootout wins in a season with 10. Ryan Miller had said it the year before, but Garon went 10-0 in that one. You look at the career shootout save percentage.
You see Lundqvist having a pretty decent save percentage, yep, as well.
I think he's the all-time victory leader in shootouts. He has 38 shootout wins for his career. That's the most. Obviously, the shootout instituted in 2005 and 2006. So great histories for both these goaltenders in terms of the shootouts through the years. As far as this year is concerned, Mathieu 0-1, allowing 1 goal on 3 shots, and Lundqvist 1-2.
Well, it appears it's going to be John Mitchell, Brad Richards, and Marion Gaborik for the their shootout three guys. It'll be Malone, Moore, and Victor Hedman for the Lightning.
Well, we showed you that look back December 23rd of 2010. They went 11 rounds in this building right before Christmas, and the Lightning won that shootout. John Mitchell, not a big score in his career, but 4 goals and 6 shots in the shootout.
John Mitchell.
He opens it up. Garon out to meet him. Mitchell. Stopped by Garon, who just reached back. And I believe with a stick got a hold of that one.
That puck was bouncing, and it, you know, it kind of hindered Mitchell, but it almost handcuffed Garon too. He just got with the toe of his pad.
Now Ryan Malone, 3 of 10, and obviously the game deciding goal last year in this building.
Now shooting for Tampa Bay, number 12, Ryan Malone.
Let's see what he's going to do with Lundqvist here. He's beating him on the glove tonight. He beat him back then on the glove. Pat save Lundqvist. Trying to go stick side.
After the first round, the Rangers 0, Tampa Bay 0. The
thing of it is, when you come stick side, he came down the left side. Watch, and he tried to get that back and couldn't get enough lift on it.
Richards has been excellent through the years and has that trademark, Chief, of just roaring in there at 100 miles an hour. They're trying to gain an advantage. Let's see what he does.
He's not coming real fast this time, but he's going to shoot.
He hits the post. Still no score in the shootout.
Comes back a little bit slowly, but watch him go back and then try to lift it up over the pad, which he did, but shaved it a little bit too far outside.
Now shooting for Tampa Bay, number
Dominic Moore, a game-deciding goal this year. You look at the career numbers. That beat the Panthers in South Florida. He scores! Dominic Moore registers the first goal of the shootout.
After two rounds, Tampa Bay won
the Wow, you know, he won it over a shootout game against the Panthers with a shot. There you see that quick shot over the glove again. And maybe they found a spot where you can best Henrik Lundqvist. There's not too many that you can.
Well, the ball is in Matthew Garand's court here.
Yep.
If he stops Gabrick, the Lightning win. Here comes Gabrick. Save
yes.
by Garand. The Lightning win the shootout. They end the five-game losing streak. And Dominic Moore, another game-deciding goal after he got us here with a tremendous individual effort on the shorthanded goal late in the third period. 3-2 the final score.
Here's the final save. Gabrick kind of paints himself into a corner, doesn't have a whole lot of room when he went to that backhand. He only had a matter of about a foot or so. Couldn't get too much of a control of the puck, and Matthew Garand stones him.
With Marty St. Louis in the hospital recovering from an injury suffered earlier today, not able to reach his 500th consecutive game, the Lightning inspired by a tremendous effort through the lineup to try to win this game. And they do it, ending the losing streak by the score of 3-2. Lightning Live coming up next.